Now, let's head towards another significant event in the context of historically unequal power relations between women and men and in close relation with issues of violence against women, gender-based discrimination and gender stereotypes. The United Nations Award contributions for women's safety. Here's a glimpse.
UN Naveen Jain Women's Safety X Prize was a $1 million global competition that challenged teams to leverage technology to empower communities with a transformative solution that ensures women's safety.
Tonight is so special. I mean, we're here at the UN awarding a prize for women's safety. What could be a bigger accomplishment? You know, women's safety is a fundamental human right, and it's not a luxury for women. And till today, we still have to worry about basic safety. So I'm just so excited to be here. We have the five top finalists here who have been tirelessly working for the past 2 years and have amazing solutions. So we're going to, you know, have a chance to see what they have, you know, what solutions they've come with, and actually award a $1 million prize to the winner.
Well, to some extent, you know, you have to create the change in culture. But the culture change doesn't happen overnight. But I think what technology does is creates a deterrent so that, you know, if you know that even 3 or 4% of women have it and you don't know who has it, that actually allows people to say, maybe I won't be doing it. It's the same reason that, you know, we know there are cameras on a traffic light or there may be a cop watching this. And the fact is, even at 1:30 at night, even though you don't see anyone, you still stop at the stoplight. So your behavior changes because when you know you could be caught.
The World Health Organization estimates that about 1 in 3 women worldwide have experienced either physical or sexual violence in their lifetime. The aim of the X Prize was to find an affordable and accessible solution for the same.
We started like a couple of years ago, and the main motivation, it came because I'm basically from Lucknow, you know, town, city in India. And when I moved to Europe, the first time I went on the road, you know, at an odd hour in the night, early morning, alone, without any feeling of fear, I realized it's a great feeling. And then I realized it shouldn't be a luxury, you know, it should be a feeling that everyone should have.
Team Saffron is a collaboration between a Chinese university, Tsinghua University, and University of Washington. And we're a spin-out company that developed this technology for women's safety and the Anuin Naveen Jain Women's X Prize.
Devices range from smart jewelry that can trigger emergency alerts to other wearables that detect physical gestures and speech recognition. The highlight was the winner that needed no or little cell network and could function without a smartphone.
What we wanted to make was a device which works completely off the grid, so it does not need a smartphone with it. So, because a lot of places and a lot of people can't really afford a smartphone, but they also need safety. So we decided to build something which was completely standalone device in itself. So it's in a form of a watch, and you know, you wear that watch in, you press, and we made something a lot different. So the signal goes through your SMS, it goes through your internet, but it can also go through your audio.
You know, when it comes to what can I handle, what's a problem that I can really have an impact on, and, you know, what can I make a difference in? So one, it's incredibly timely in the news, right? The Me Too movement is here, and it kind of stirs everyone up so that people support your cause when you're talking about it.
There is a story behind this. One of our founders, Leo Bereshchansky, has close friend who was attacked by her ex-boyfriend, and she tried to fight him for an hour, calling for help, but no one heard this call, and the guy actually held both of your hands, so she couldn't reach for the phone or use the pepper spray or somehow protect herself from this unfortunate development. So then Leo decided that in this situation, women need something to send a distress signal, even if both of your hands are somehow restricted.
The idea of the program was to make the world safer. And if a society empowered by technology can keep women safe, everyone will be safer, including vulnerable populations like children and elders.
Well, that's all in Community Roundup today. Agar aap koi sujav dena chahte hai, to please email us on communitynews@tvasiausa.com. Like us on Facebook too. Our Facebook ID is facebook.com/TV Asia USA. Milenge fir ek baar kal community roundup mein. Tab tak dekhte rahiye TV Asia. Namaskar.